AEM Desktop App 2.0 provides a rich interface for asset discovery. Using the UI, you can quickly zero in on the desired asset by browsing, searching, and sorting your AEM assets DAM repository. Let's have a quick look at the browse and navigation options. When we log in, the root folder of the DAM repository is displayed. You can further browse into the various folders that are available. At times, if the app has refresh issues, you can either use the refresh option at the top here, or you can do a hard refresh by right clicking and from the context menu select refresh. When you do a hard refresh, the app does not remember the last folder that you were browsing and you will have to browse again. That's a little bit of troubleshooting tip as we go along. So at the very top you would see a couple of options to create new folders, upload assets, refresh the app, open the preferences window, open the help documentation, and log out and exit the app. At the bottom toolbar here, you can see that the app allows you either to jump directly to one of the folders in the hierarchy that you are browsing, or just go one level up using this back arrow button, left arrow button key here. The more nuanced option to work with the assets are either this checkbox to select all the assets or sort the assets based on the three parameters, which are either alphabetical or based on the size or based on the last modified date here. I'm going to do a quick sort, and the app allows you to do a sort based on ascending and descending order. So the default is alphabetical. You can always select one asset at a time or a few assets in the view by clicking on the small thumbnail here. The number of the selected assets are displayed here, and a few generic actions that you can take, the common actions that you can take on all the assets, which is open the folder, locally downloaded folder, that the assets are downloaded into. This works only after you have downloaded the asset locally. This option is to download the asset locally. The status here in the second column here, it tells you whether the asset is available only in the cloud or whether it is downloaded locally and is available on your file system. Let me quickly show you the change in the asset status. It says available locally. After you edit an asset, it says locally edited, and that tells you that it's ready to be uploaded. When you are ready, you can upload these locally edited assets. More about it in a later video. This pop-up menu here displays allows you to filter the assets which based on what assets in your local file system are edited locally, which are ready to be uploaded, so that you can zero in on all the changed assets and upload them in one go, no matter which folder the assets reside in. And this asset transfer option here gives you a list of all the uploaded and downloaded assets from a particular session. This list is not preserved across sessions, but let me quickly show you. I downloaded an asset right now, so this icon here represents that this was downloaded, and the amount of data that is transferred. And you can always clear this list because this is a transient list that is only retained for one session, for the particular session in progress. You can download entire folders by selecting the folders, or a few assets by selecting a few assets. You can always click on an asset to look at a larger thumbnail and a couple of basic metadata, like for example the dimensions of the asset or the path on the repository, AEM repository, and the format the asset is present in. The detailed actions are available on an asset from these three ellipses here. Based on the permissions that your login has, you can see various options. Administrators get to see the maximum of 7 options are available. Here the same set of options are available when you view the larger thumbnail. These 7 options are available. You can either open an asset just to view it, you can just download the asset and do nothing but just fetch it from the server and download it locally, maybe to work on it later when you are offline. You can toggle the status between checkout and check-in. You can launch, select edit and launch the asset, launch the native application to edit the asset in one go. You can reveal the asset in the local folder by selecting this reveal file option. You can delete the asset completely from the AEM assets repository as well as the local repository. You can open it in AEM assets web. You can open it in the web browser to see the location of the asset and to work on it in AEM assets using the open in web option. So these are the few basic actions that you can take, and the various UI, the controls that are available on the UI. The same set of options are available on the search results. Let me quickly search for assets related to running. The usability is fantastic. You would think the search results are as good as browsing a folder. You can look at the various assets, you can select multiple assets, you can either download them locally, you can open and edit them one at a time, or you can take various actions that are available on one asset at a time, or you can open a larger thumbnail, view the metadata, take any action that you want to take, or go back to the search results. The AEM desktop app also allows you to search when the number of assets are very large. For example, I don't have a folder with too many assets. I'm going to just search for all the assets in the repository using the wildcard search here. You can continue to browse the search results, and this is also applicable to browsing a folder, any particular folder. The application allows for an infinite scroll. You can continue to scroll to locate the asset that you are looking for. Of course, the robust search functionality and the search and the sort functionalities should allow you to zero in on your asset without having to scroll as much.